Hi guys, so in this video I am going to talk about a course that I recently just completed from Walden University in their nurse practitioner program. So a little bit about myself. As you guys already know, I am a registered nurse. I graduated from a brick and mortar school, and then I transitioned to RN to BSN program online over at Western Governors University. And then at one point in time, I actually was in the route of doing my master's in nursing informatics over at WGU. However, I had a change of heart. So now I am here at Walden University. Well, not technically here at Walden University, but now I am at Walden University doing my adult gerontology primary care nurse practitioner. So that's AGPCNP, right? So a couple of my friends asked me, why did I not go with FNP, which is family nurse practitioner? Well, the answer to that is so simple. Just because I did not, there's actually two things why I didn't go for my FNP. Number one is because I primarily like to work with adult and geriatrics population. So I am not interested at all in the pediatrics population. And then number two, if I'm not interested in pediatrics, in the pediatric population, so that means if I do my FNP, I would still have to do my rotation or my clinicals with the pediatric population, and I'm not gonna enjoy it. So I didn't want to waste my time, so here I am in the adult gerontology primary care nurse practitioner. I'm happy so far. All right, before we get started, let's do the housekeeping in order. I wanted to remind you guys that I am not affiliated with Walden University. They are not paying me. This is not a sponsored video. So anything that I talk about here is based solely from my experiences and sometimes research. All right, so the second thing that I wanted to talk to you guys about is, you guys already know, the subscribing, the commenting, and the liking. In this channel, I mostly talk about my journey to school and hoping to motivate you in some way. So if you guys like what I do, or if you guys like this channel, please don't forget to subscribe. All right, so EBP, right? Essentials of Evidence-Based Practice, or EBP. I'm gonna tell you right now, the book, this is the book. I don't know where I'm gonna put it, right here. Yeah, so the book. I actually didn't buy the book. It's fairly cheap. I am gonna tell you guys that. It's definitely cheap, but I didn't buy the book. This is why I didn't buy the book. I'm gonna tell you, because I have three other books. One from my ASM program, and then number two, a PDF version from my BSN program. And number three, another PDF version from my master's program over at WGU. Yeah, I know, I took EBP master's level already, but Walden didn't take they took some credits from Western Governors University, but a couple of things that they didn't take, and one of them is evidence-based practice. So yeah, I have three books. So I figured evidence-based is evidence-based, right? So it's the core value, or the core of what you're learning anyways in EBP is really what? Is really researching how to research properly. So I figured those three books, whatever I need, I will definitely find the information that I need. So I'm not saying that you guys shouldn't buy the book, right? What I'm saying is that I didn't buy the book because I have three other evidence-based EBP books. So if you guys think that, ooh, the lighting is really did suck in there. If you guys think that you guys will be okay, because EBP is EBP. Like I said, you're researching how to properly research. Don't buy the book. Again, the book is cheap enough, so it's okay. It's not gonna hurt you.
So what are you guys gonna talk about in the discussion board? Same thing. You're talking about researching how to research stuff. And you're gonna talk about qualitative, quantitative. Yeah, so in the whole course, again, there's 4 discussion boards, there's 5 assignments. So those 5 assignments consist of writing, research, because again, it's evidence-based practice and you're researching how to properly research. What else? Oh, there's 1 quiz, right? But it's open book, obviously. You take your time.
All right, so do you guys remember Pico, or Peacock, or however you say it? We first got introduced to this in our ASM program, and then in the BSM program, you have to write and research about it. And then, of course, in the master level program, it's more elaborated or more in depth. Did I say that right? Usually, I would have my daughter, I would have to ask my daughter how you say it. I promise I write better in English than speaking English. But anyway, Pico, Peacock. In the master's level program, it's more elaborated, it's more in depth, right? Let me remind you what it stands for. P for people, I for intervention, C for communication, no, C for comparison, O for outcome, T for time. Do you remember now? So yeah. You're gonna write about that. Resources. You guys need to take advantage of resources that Walden University provides you with, especially the Writing Center. Like I said, in this particular course, there's a lot of writing, researching, PowerPoint, presentation, things like that. So Writing Center would be a great resource for you guys. It's free of charge. Take advantage of that if you guys are not good with APA format. There's a whole video of that, a whole page, a whole resource in the writing resource website within Walden University, Walden University Library. A lot of things that you guys can use there.
All right, to summarize everything, as you guys already know, there's gonna be 4 discussion board. You will have to do the first initial post, and then you then have to reply to 2 of your classmates, whether you agree or disagree to what they said. And also, there's gonna be 5 assignments in total. I'm just not sure of the numbers on how many research paper you have to submit, and as well as PowerPoint, but I know towards the end, you do have to submit your final PowerPoint with a voiceover. There's also gonna be 1 quiz in the whole 6 modules.
I had to go outside because I had to let the dog out. But anyhow, I wanted to kind of just give a few more quick pointers before I let you guys go. So the first thing that came into my head was please citate and reference your work properly. APA format, as you guys know, discussion board, your research paper, your PowerPoint, it all goes through what we call a safe assign in Walden University, and that scans through plagiarism. You do not want to get ding for plagiarism, okay? So please cite and reference properly. The second thing that I wanted to tell you guys is that if you guys are having a hard time, or if you guys are having any issues, the first person that you guys should be reaching out to is your course instructor. He or she would be able to help you out and figure things with you. Of course, the Walden University nursing team. You guys can reach out to them, you can email them, you can call them. Writing center, I already mentioned that though. I wanted to mention if you guys have any questions for me, if I can answer them, I will be more than happy to assist you. I wish you guys all the best. Bye-bye.